shit, ladies and gentlemen. How you doing out there? This is Intergalactic Interviews, and this is episode 119, ladies and gentlemen.
What?
119, yes, said the expression of our guest, the Humphries. But before we get into that, I think we should let you know about a very exciting opportunity. You know what that opportunity is? I bet you think I'm going to talk about Float House. Nope. First, we're going to mention that you can catch Katie Ellen Humphries at a couple shows coming up. Very, very important. There's a comedy festival coming up here in Vancouver in the Lower Mainland. We really think you should check out. First show we want to let you know about is Katie will be appearing at Barely Legal on the 17th. It's a great show. I think he said it was award-winning.
I did not.
That's okay. Don't worry. I'm sure that's in its
future. It is award worthy.
Award worthy. Yes.
Absolutely.
That's the word I should have used. Worthy. That's okay. It's just an excuse for me to say Barely Legal again on the 17th of February. Go ahead and check that out. She'll also be appearing at Stacked on the 20th. Kino on February 21st. And she is the guest comedian on Sunday Service, February 26th. All very important. Go check them out if you can. If you go to all of them, Katie will supply you with a stamp card, and you have four spaces to stamp. And then, I don't know, high-five you or something. Katie will make up the prize. Look, this isn't about me, okay? It's about Katie. So I'm just trying to let you know. Ladies and gentlemen, I wanted to actually let you know about another opportunity, though. Our podcast is very happy to be sponsored by Float House. Float House is an amazing premier destination for you to check out your isolation tank experiences. If you don't know what that is, it's floating in a tank and unlocking the mysteries of your mind. I know, right? Who could ever not want to take part in that unless you're really comfortable with your situation? And then maybe you want to unlock it just as like an experience. That's the kind of thing. But if you are looking for some time to yourself to kind of maybe just relax for a while, it's like a spa for your mind. It's amazing. I love it. We float. You should float. And if you want to use our podcast promo code, what is that podcast promo code, Michael Saavedra?
That would be II Podcast.
Goddamn right. It's fucking II Podcast. F words and swears through it.
Now that's the letter I.
Yes. The letter I podcast. You'd be surprised if you knew how many times this came up. It's not.
I still feel
nautical.
Like we should get the other one too.
Yeah, the nautical one,
yeah,
right?
It's not that if someone II. Screws up, it's covered.
Like, yeah, it's not like covered. A salute, like, aye, aye, captain. It's not like that.
I still feel like we should have it.
Yeah.
I think there's a limit.
Right. That's right. And then there's a character limit, and there's only so much room in the computer, actually. If you want to use our podcast promo code, II Podcast, you get 20% off your next float. It's a great deal. I think it's amazing. And, of course, we would not... want to miss out on our other sponsor. Our co-sponsor on this is actually as well Off the Rail Brewing, and they've supplied us with every episode that we are kind enough to walk over there. They will give us free liquor, and we appreciate that.
Who doesn't?
Yeah, for our guests and for ourselves to enjoy, and they always give us a varying taste. Which particular brand is this one this week, Michael?
Today we are drinking the Cycle Path Lager.
Ooh.
Yes, just a nice, clean lager.
Have we had this before?
I think we have. Yeah, I think we were drinking this earlier, like summertime.
Summertime. This is really nice.
Just a nice, clean, old-fashioned lager. it's fantastic.
It's a clean drinking taste. Beer.
If you're thinking about, you know, I drink Budweiser or any of that nonsense beer.
How dare you talk about such a... juggernaut of a brand. You're opening us up to a lot of exposure right now. Legal exposure.
Well, don't drink that. Drink this. Support your local breweries.
Yeah, I don't think they give a fuck, to be honest with you. Yeah, Off the Rail Brewing is an amazing place, and if you like our show, go over there and give them a like or let them know you heard about them on our show. I'm sure they'd love that.
They definitely do.
Definitely do, and buy their beer. We'd like that. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, our guest, without further ado, she is fantastic. She's funny. She is long overdue to be on this show, and as fate would have it, we had a rescheduling and then a rescheduling just to make this day. It was already written in stone. It was written in the stars. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Katie Ellen Humphries.
Hello.
Yes. That's great. I feel like I've been talking for a long time already.
So it was a lot of ado.
That's right. I want to start this off right away. I got a question for you. I heard this question on the weekend, and I am I don't know, it's like on my mind to ask you, and I want to know how you feel. The question was, if you were to be famous for anything other than your profession, what is it you would want to be famous for?
Oh, saving a child from a well.
Wow.
There you go.
Well saver.
Yeah.
Is that the correct term? Is that
why not?
Modern term? Term. That's a well wisher, but
yeah. Well wisher.
Yeah.
Hey, oh, this guy.
They're just for posers who are like, I mean, I'd like to save a kid from a well, but I've been busy.
You answered that so quickly. Have you ever had the opportunity?
Never.
Never.
I mean, thankfully.
With all the wells that are around right now.
Yeah.
All the open wells.
We live in a city full of wells.
There's like, you
they're
know,
probably just covered. Like, they're out there.
Yeah, they're pretty out there.
I mean, I would also take, you know, salvaging a human, a child from like rapids or something like that, like a river situation.
Okay, so
I like a lifeguard. General,
just saving, you know, a child. So you just, yeah, want to be like some kind of hero, local, maybe work your way up to regional hero.
Yeah. And maybe like a brochure tour.
That's right. And then become like, you know.
This is where they saved the kid.
That's right.
Right here.
Ooh, I see. And then you become like a Western hero. Right?
Oh, maybe made for TV movie.
Right?
Mm.
Who would play you in the movie?
Oh, Sean Astin.
Rudy.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
People are like, Samwise? Nope.
Rudy.
No. Can't talk about Rudy without saying Ryan Williams. That was a really fucking hilarious conversation last time he was on the show. Sorry.
I love Ryan Williams. Also, check out him. So funny.
He's very funny. We like him. You're very funny. Today, you have put on several miles just to get to this show. You were booked for a corporate gig.
And
it was a noon corporate gig. To which I said, LOL, seriously. And you said, of course. So I would like you to walk me through this really quick because it's fresh in your mind. I'd love to know what this was like today. Please just start right from where you open your eyes. Boom. What happens?
All right. Well, first of all, I open them at 6:25 a.m. because soundcheck is at 7 a.m.
What the fuck?
That seems early.
They need the conference room at 8 for their conference.
That's I've done sound engineering for various corporate events. Saavedra has done sound engineering for various corporate events.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, I can tell you right now, with authority, that's not necessary. That absolutely not necessary. 7 a.m. sound check. Nope. Okay. Continue.
I mean, it was helpful. So the show that I was doing, it was a live version of The Debaters.
Right.
So not taped for radio. The Debaters is a show on CBC Radio.
Mm-hmm.
But so this one was special just for this conference. The conference was the ICSA International Shopping Centers Council.
Interesting. Yep. The ISC?
No.
I don't know. I'm making up acronyms.
Like anyone, home shopping or something like
International
that?
International Council of Shopping Centers. Pardon me.
Oh, okay.
ICSC.
Hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. So I think in total there's like about 2,000 people at this conference, and it's people who, mall architects and retailers and real estate folks and whatnot.
It's a good mix.
It's been a riveting conference.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have to imagine.
I'm sure it's pretty
these guys
interesting
probably
from
actually,
some certain perspective.
These guys probably party hard.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You'd have to.
Yeah. Yeah, they were up there to party and to go dog sledding and stuff or whatever.
Oh,
I don't know, whatever you do in the snow. I don't know what you do in the snow.
We didn't say it was in Whistler.
Oh,
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah.
So
did we
was
not
in,
say it?
It was
in
Whistler.
Sorry. Yeah.
Not in like Vancouver.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's
so
also travel involved. Yeah.
That's right. Oh, man. I've never felt. So it's just been like 2 days of fantasy camp of pretending to be rich. Because Sunday afternoon, a black Lincoln Navigator pulled up at my house and drove me to a resort town.
Oh, shit.
That's nice.
Yeah. And then even at the hotel, I got upgraded to this room. To like what they literally called our hotel within a hotel, that had its own private like anything the regular hotel had. They were like, we have continental breakfast,
like an isolated hotel.
But you have deluxe continental breakfast.
Yeah.
Oh, what's that?
What does that mean?
And you have your like your own concierge desk, and you could check out without going downstairs, and all of the, it was like
so
bizarre.
See the peasants.
I just want to know what deluxe continental.
Yeah.
What is it like? Muffins that you know the other people just don't.
No
have.
Warm muffins probably.
No,
warm.
It is like the best
warm
brunch
muffins.
You've ever been to. Like I don't know what continent this is, but I like
haven't
it.
Heard of here.
The best continent.
Just it's a whole. It's a continent that's just for rich people.
That's ridiculous.
It was so bizarre.
Did they have to like pull down like a bookshelf?
Yeah, it was real secret. At one point, so there was four of us in this traveling in this group, and two of us were staying on this floor and two weren't. And we tried to go there for breakfast meeting, and they were like, no guests.
No guests?
Yeah.
You're like, but I'm not a guest, I'm talent. They're like, no.
No, so like he and the other guy who were staying on that floor, we could have gone, but we couldn't bring our riffraff fifth floor.
I'm sorry, yeah. Sorry, Mr. Sidhu.
Actual scum.
Oh, they were lower tier. Yeah. I understand now, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Actually, there's one thing I want to ask you. The driver on the way up.
Yeah.
Were you like, no conversation? Like, he didn't want to talk? Or did they talk your ear off?
I did not want to talk, and he did not either.
It was great.
A little pleasantries off top. Oh, Whistler. Oh,
sure, you're
weather.
a kind person, right?
Et cetera. Cool. Yeah.
Nothing wrong with
that. I'm going to drive now.
Yeah. Yeah, as I understand, Steve, who's the host of Debaters, his driver was very chatty. And unlike the rest of us that came up from Vancouver, he had flown in that day from Fort Lauderdale. So he'd already had like a 20-hour travel day when he got in this car.
Oh, man.
And then she wanted to talk the whole way up.
Is he a fifth floor person?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
Nope.
Okay.
I see. Okay.
No, I wouldn't know that story otherwise because we wouldn't have spoken.
Okay. Fifth floor fugly, I think is what they were calling them. No, that's pretty crazy though. So like you're experiencing, I like how you put that, fantasy camp for the rich.
Well, because everyone else in Love's Lounge too, like they have all the gear because they knew they were coming to stay at Whistler on purpose.
Right,
and
of course.
Like they just look like they're out of an 80s ski movie.
Whatever, Darsh. Like, yeah, totally, right?
You're like, oh, why are you wearing a fur hat?
Yeah, it looks like they do all their shopping in like Sky Mall magazines. That kind of thing, yeah.
Yeah, and then the gig itself was the best possible scenario for a corporate in that it is this show that a number of people in the audience already know because it's this long-running, decade-plus successful show on Canadian radio.
Right.
And it's a format, so you don't have to do your own act because we did do stand-up off the top. We did maybe a 10-minute set each, mm-hmm. and it was myself and Ivan Decker.
Killer.
Very, very funny.
We love Ivan. Yeah, absolutely.
They loved him as well. They were not as crazy about me.
Oh, God, no.
Is
this one of those things where comics are like, even if you murder, they're like, I was okay. Like,
no, but it's also just better, like, just stylistically, he has this, like, genius observational style. And so everyone there was like, yeah, I know what you're talking about. And then for me, it's like, it's lunchtime.
By the way, in a conference room.
Full of mostly middle-aged to middle-aged plus white dudes. And I'm like, do you guys want to hear about my burgeoning womanhood? No? I get it.
They're like trying to pass the salt and shit like that.
Enjoy your sandwich.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, there was one young woman up front, and I was like, this is all for you, girl. She was laughing. I was like, yeah, I get it. Okay.
I hear you, definitely.
But then the debate was amazing, and that went very well.
Well, that's good. Now, because it wasn't recorded like they generally are for radio,
mm-hmm.
Was there any kind of like setup script kind of like, because it's more of like a traveling promo of the show, essentially, like in that format. But
yeah, like, no, we hadn't done the debate before. It wasn't something like that where we were repackaging one. We had... In this way, the only time I didn't feel like I was at Fantasy Rich Camp, I was like, oh no, y'all are the rich people because you told me what to do this debate about.
Oh, okay. That's wealth.
It's your job, and we are the court jesters.
They're like, yeah, don't you like this? Yeah, it's like, you can go back to the fifth floor after. But don't you love this right now? It's amazing, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it was pretty amazing.
That's crazy.
It was pretty great.
Well, that's good. Well, I'm glad you had a good time. And then after this, by the way, this was today. We're talking about this was like weeks ago or something.
It was weeks ago.
Yeah,
it was this whole other life when I had money and a future. And then because it's also
private floors and all.
So Sunday I left my apartment and I got into this chauffeured Lincoln Navigator, but then I forgot that that Lincoln Navigator was going to bring me back
to reality,
to my no bedroom apartment.
Yeah, no bedroom.
Which I'd also torn apart while I was packing, as I was like, I don't know, what do you wear for business casual? Ah. And I had to come back like, all right, that terrible thing I did in here yesterday.
Hey, come back to a disaster, and you're like, fuck.
Yeah. Like, well, that's right. This is my life.
Yeah, some fifth floor was hanging out.
No concierge.
God yeah. Damn, yeah. Oh my God.
No
that,
special
that
breakfast.
Lounge, because when that breakfast is done, like a couple more, there's food in that room all day. Because when that beautiful brunch is done, then it just goes to like light snacks until an awesome pre-dinner spread, and then until 10 p.m. when there's like dessert.
How many visits did you make to the?
I mean, not nearly enough. I was trying to steal more tea.
That's all the carry, like your bag. Just see what we got here.
That's hilarious. I like that. But what do you make of? First of all, wait. I can't go farther. Then I have to address this. Your no bedroom apartment. So is it like an open concept kind of? Like...
Oh yeah, it's like a cool like art. It's like a lofty live work. I just don't have walls, man. Don't. Come on.
I hear you.
It's a bachelor suite.
I hear you. Break. I hear you. I'm not trying to
No.
to call you
I up. Mean, it is a large apartment for a small apartment.
I like these, like their open concept, like style.
Yeah.
I feel like I always wanted to stay.
I just feel freer, you know? Like right? You just don't feel boxed in and like mm-hmm. the light and I don't know, man.
Yeah. Going very left wing on me right now. Yeah. Speaking of which, there was protest downtown today again for the end of the world or that stuff that's going on, you know.
They are against the end of the world?
No, I think they're protesting how the world's ending.
Yeah.
But that it is ending or something to that effect. And I almost went down.
Is it like when Seinfeld ended, people were like, "Oh, I don't
people know. Yeah, it was very like it seems very dramatic." But I almost went down there today just cuz I wanted like historically say I was like, oh, I was like, I'm not supporting either way. I mean, I'm not really for people being assholes or like telling other people to do with their body. That's not what I'm about. I think that's really pretty common sense. But there is also like some really like condescending type folk that are attending these like pro rally kind of stuff. So I kind of just wanted to go down just to be like, just to stand there and maybe hear some hey hey, ho ho, or whatever chants they wanted to use today. I wanted to go down there and check it out, but like most people in protests, apathy came over me, and I was like, nah, that's okay. I think I'll just clean the condo and just that's it.
Who's gonna throw a condo at me now?
We just yeah. Oh.
Just got my no
better
mind. Clean my yeah.
Oh, and you yours is clean. I get it. Okay. Yeah. That's a twofer.
Figured I would just clean my open concept lounge. Lounge. Yeah, I don't know.
But I did go down to the Women's March not long ago, which was real
dope.
Was
this the one that just happened, the trillion million people?
Yeah, that was the one on the day after the inauguration.
Right.
Like 21.
Right. So that was my next question. What was the last protest you attended? So that was the...
That was it, yeah.
Did you make a sign?
I did not make a sign in classic white girl fashion. I found a sign that someone else dropped. I was like, I guess this is my sign now.
What did it
say? I asked around a lot.
Black and proud.
Like, yeah.
You're like, this is me, through and through. I like that.
It was a Malala sign. I had like a picture of Malala, and then it said.
Wait, what?
Malala, come on, read a book.
Jesus, that's my line. Telling people to read a book. How
I
do
did,
you?
Wait, I did mumble a lot.
What is it? Tell me.
Malala?
Pretend I don't know because I don't.
It's like the Muslim girl that got shot in the face.
Oh,
and
Jesus.
She like survived and now she's like a Nobel Peace Prize winner.
Oh, yeah. I know about
What's
that.
What's wrong with you?
Oh, yeah. How could I forget?
No, I did not make sense, but the signs were on point. There's a lot of real good signs.
Yeah?
Yeah. A lot of Carrie Fisher signs.
What? Why? Because she was such an outspoken feminist. Is that why?
Yeah. I think she just had a lot of good lines and then a lot of people were like, because they like, because some were Carrie Fisher signs and some were Princess Leia signs.
People can't separate the person from the character. I love that.
But no, I think some people were championing like Princess Leia inspires me. That's so strong. But then some people just had like written out quotes of Carrie Fisher, like from her works.
I love that. I love the idea that someone would have like a Princess Leia, like maybe like not like iconic golden bikini Princess Leia, but like
no, she did not make as many appearances.
Right, yeah, but like Princess Alderaan, yeah, like Princess of Alderaan, white gown.
I just wanted to be quotes that made no sense
yeah.
towards the women's thing. And it was just like...
She's like, into the garbage chute, flyboy. And you're just
Yeah. I mean, I feel like that was still...
Why?
Yeah. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I did meet a friend at the Women's March. And we met at the SkyTrain station at Waterfront. And there's a Starbucks there. Very busy pre-March.
Yeah, I'm shocked.
Getting your... pre-March tea on.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, just this real beautiful joining of women's voices as a drink would come up. And then a chorus of women together would shout, soy chai latte, so that people would hear when their drink was up. And I was like, we're really working together.
That's right. That's the mini protest right
Yeah,
there.
I was like, that might be our chant.
That's hilarious. That is...
Yeah, it was.
I love this so much. I really wish I would have went now. No, I'm really wishing
it. Oh man, it was real great. The other great thing that happened during the march is that so it was on a Saturday, mm-hmm. in Vancouver, and it was very well attended. So there's like thousands of people down there, and it's started at 10, so it's not prime time businessman hours, but there's still like a couple of areas where. There would be like a couple times I noticed you'd look up and a tall building would have some guys out on a balcony and it would be like three middle-aged white dudes in business suits just staring down at everyone. Felt very Mad Max.
Dude, that's like they on
weren't
a Saturday.
They weren't taking photos. They weren't filming. They weren't doing anything. Just standing there staring.
On a Saturday.
Lording over you.
Yeah. And any,
counting money.
Counting, yeah.
Any vehicles that were getting stopped, like inconvenience that couldn't get around, was all... just dudes in suits, which you don't even see in Vancouver very often.
That's really that's almost kind of like they wanted to be there almost a little bit. The fact that you'd like, okay, lord out of your castle essentially,
yeah.
right? Because like, that's what it was. They're like looking down on the plebes and they're like, look
like,
at these.
Just ever so slightly bemused, like, isn't that cute?
Yeah. That's like cracking the heads of puppies. Just... raining the blood on the people. You know, just regular casual business things that happen all the time.
And the march culminated at Trump Tower, which prior to that march, I did not know where that was.
I don't know where that is right now.
I didn't, because everyone, like, I knew there was one. So I'd heard of it. And
I walked
knew
by
that
it a couple
it was,
times.
Like,
is it close
downtown.
By here where we are right now?
It's very close.
Don't give our location up.
It's very close. We're
here
it's by
in
the,
our bunker?
That food store.
Well, it's downtown. Yeah.
Yeah.
I hear you. The food store.
And what
Sorry.
Is that one? It's the
Grocery.
expensive Safeway or expensive Save on Foods.
Mm. Expensive
Not choices.
Safe? Is this like
yeah,
special
it's the other
breakfast?
One. It's like Whole Foods, but Save on
oh,
Foods.
Oh, like
brand.
Urban Fair?
Yeah, Urban Fair. It's just down the street from Urban Fair.
Okay.
It was all covered up. Yeah, I think they had the sign had not been revealed yet, but it was. And it did seem so strange.
That's weird.
Yeah.
So like the sign hadn't been revealed, but so what was it like under?
No,
like,
it's there.
No, they were covering
now.
It because it was attracting a lot of like.
Yeah, it kept getting
vandalized.
Yeah, vandalism. Yeah.
The bad funny. Part is that there's a really, really good Chinese food restaurant that is opened inside of Trump Tower. Now it just feels bad. Like I want to go there,
but you can't go there.
I don't want.
You
like,
probably shouldn't go.
Hey, like you can't go past all those people. And be like, I just really want to try their egg rolls right now. Like, I just really want them. They look so good on the pictures. Like. Can't go into this building.
Oh, how many rallies or signs do you think you'd have to like have under your belt like to be able to walk in there? Like how many buttons with various like slogans to walk in there and people be like, look, this guy looks like he knows what he's doing. This girl, she looks like she knows what she's doing. I think they just like egg rolls. Like they're not
just really want.
Just gotta get a job there. I think
that's right. You gotta work there. work at Trump Tower.
Yeah.
That's crazy. It's crazy things going on right now. I almost feel like it's like fucking hack kind of to like talk about this, but then it's too much every day to like not address it. Do you know what I mean? Like if, you know?
Yeah, I'm going back and forth and like Sarah Shaver had, the comedian had this great tweet that was like, so something about like in terms of news, should we just take shifts now? Like I'll do Mondays. You know, because you can't take it in all day, every day, because it's too much. But on the other hand, if you just completely disengage, then that's ignorant and you don't want
to,
like...
I completely agree. So that's, like, what are your options? To be completely over-encumbered with, like, all these conflicting messages, both from administration and from people at times, you know, and, like, to have just this chaos of information coming your way. Do you have that? Or do you have, like, the complete just disconnect from the grid, ignorance, and people are like, what? Like, for instance, that girl you mentioned earlier, the shot in the face girl.
Oh, yeah.
She's
in it.
I will probably shock you with, I'm like, oh, I know A, B, C, and D, and E, and all this stuff about this kind of stuff. But then something like that, I have no idea. Just totally slipped my whole radar of things I need to know or something. Like, I had no idea. I've never heard of that in my life. Did I?
I think you would. If you saw a photo of her, you would know.
Like, was there
certain? It's just there's so much news right now that, like,
I've never heard of that.
You're not going to be up on every single piece. Like, there's just, in the last year, it's been just an overbearing. Yeah. Like, it's overbearing. I know of that, but, like, it takes a few minutes to register now because there's just stuff happening so rapid fire. It seems like you can't possibly be kept up with everything.
Yeah, it seems like, what's the solution there, Katie? Well, how do you figure that out?
What?
Fix the world right now.
Sort it out for us.
Yeah. No, like, no, seriously, though, like, how do you go about this, though? Like, how do you fix, like, are we really looking at 3 years and 11 months of this? Like, is that really, like,
we're on
the reality
day eight
of this?
Or nine now. Yeah, so, like, nine, not even.
Or yeah, right, yeah. I guess so, yeah. C-Mart with the exact count. Hilarious. What do you do? What do you do? Because, like, I mean, at this stage, I feel I'm already swamped with, like, nonsense. Yeah. I'm like, what do you do? It's, I don't know, it's kind of crazy.
It is great. I mean, I think disengaging entirely for me is not an option, and it's not something that I would recommend for any sort of engaged, empathetic human. But
you could have just stopped at human.
Not just, all just humans are engaged. A lot of people, I think, oh, it doesn't affect me, and that which I believe to be incorrect. Again,
I agree
if you with are
that.
A human
yep,
being,
I agree with that. Yeah.
But also self-care is incredibly important, and you need to, like, know where you're at. And
I've been hearing that a lot recently. Self-care.
Yeah.
I've not heard that term since like clean etiquette when you're a teenager and growing up. And they're like, self-care is very important. Make sure you shower every day.
Take a shower. Yeah, you'll stink.
You're an oily motherfucker.
Right.
Yeah. Right. That kind of stuff. Self-care, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we are in a haven of self-care right now.
I was going to say, isn't that how we got elected, with too many people self-caring?
Yeah.
Oh, right, yeah. Oh,
C-Mart with the dagger.
Yeah.
Nice. Way to drop the anchor on them. Good job. You're right, though. We are right now in this, like, this location we're at right now is, like, the embodiment of self-care. You come in here. You may be an individual with a completely different background from the person beside you in the lounge or in the tank next to you, like in the room next door or whatever. But when you come to a place like Float House like this, you have pretty much the same desire. You want to better yourself. You want to have a better grasp on your situation. You want to, like, just have a moment to, like, kind of think things through. That's what I use the tank for. I like to relax and, like, just kind of decide things. Like, when I produce, I have so many like song arrangement considerations, like mixing and notes and things like that, that, like, this helps me sort it out. It, like, sits me down and do it. Have you ever floated before?
No. I am currently in possession of no less than 3 float gift certificates.
Shut up.
Yeah, I got them all last year, which is, like, a real message. They're like, hey, you boring.
You gotta have a good conversation with yourself.
Yeah, yeah. 3 different people are like, hey, 3 you seem people. Real tired.
Oh my God. 3 different people.
Yeah.
Listen.
I'm very tedious.
Yeah. Something about
this. Yeah, yes. I'd like
I'm
you
not,
to
I have not a lot of interest, and there's not a lot going on. But I've always been very intimidated by it. And then I came in to meet y'all, and even just the lounge, I was like, no, I love it here.
Yeah.
It's the best.
It is nice here.
Do you have questions? I'll help you out right now. Let's talk you into this right now. If you have, first of all...
Will I get cold?
No. You get, first of all, you get your own private room. So you get your own like house coat and slippers and all that stuff. So you're immediately warm. You do it.
Is there a continental breakfast?
No deluxe.
Special. It's continental.
It's the legitimate continental breakfast. Yeah. Breakfast where you're like, here's a muffin and a, like a whole piece of cantaloupe.
Yeah, it's like, no, they do have like fantastic blessed cucumber water. I don't. Asterix may not be blessed.
I do love cucumber.
There's a lot of rocks in it.
Yeah, there's rocks from like, I don't know where, but like, I'll tell you
what.
The guys that own this place, the Zaremba brothers, they host Vancouver Real, which is another podcast that is recorded here in this location. And the guys that own Float House, that's them, the Zaremba brothers. They are like so on top of this spiritual journey, like the metaphysical side of things. They follow all different aspects of it that allow you to like maximize your efficiency here, essentially. Ugh. So like everything is so designed for you to have a good time. So when you're like, do you get cold? Nope, never that. It'll never happen. There's so much engineering that goes into just the room to make it soundproof, to make it like watertight. Because you think about it, like this is an aquatic in reality, like we say tanks and stuff like that, but like really this is like an aquatic facility. Like there's a number of,
yeah, it smells so good in here.
You can feel
you can feel the humidity. Yeah, the humidity. Yeah. The room. Yeah. Yeah, it's so amazing. But like, you get your own shower. You shower first. You're naked. Get naked.
Then I do not care for showering
at all.
Yeah, not a fan.
Like just in general.
Yeah, yeah, straight up not a fan.
You bath.
No.
Just not
like
not
bathing across the board is not. Yeah. I do not. But I love to be submerged. So the floating part I like.
I see. Okay.
I love to be in water. Mm. I do not like to be like splashed with water.
Oh, I see.
Well, that's a very unique shower request.
Yeah, I mean.
I mean, I would.
What about a hot tub?
I fall in and out of love with showering.
With no jets. No jets.
Yeah, I'll be honest. I fall in and out of love with showering. Sometimes I feel like. It sounds like the laziest thing, but it's like I just can't be bothered sometimes.
Yeah, you.
I
think,
live for showering. Fuck.
Yeah, no. I'm like
shower for most dudes. But then there's a lot of work that comes after showering as a gal. You got this like
fucking the hair.
Blanket on your head. That's you got to deal true. With.
I never considered that a blanket of hair.
Yeah. Like, what am I gonna do with this now?
Just don't live in like some luxurious condo where I have like nice new.
Get
shower.
The fuck
I
out like of here!
I got an apartment shower where I'm taller than the.
No.
So it's just like cranking my neck. To, like,
I've showered at Mike's place before.
It's not great.
That sounds brutal.
I've showered at Mike's place before, and you know, I crane my neck.
It doesn't work.
It's the worst.
It's like
fucking
I enjoy
thing.
A bath. But apartment baths, you ain't gonna fit in there. Like, it's not like good. Just like.
I got a new shower head put in. They replaced our shower heads, and I had a new shower head for 2 days. That was so beautiful. So much pressure, so nice.
Right.
And 2 days after they put in this new one, they did low flow ones through the whole building.
No.
And I was like, listen, I shower like twice a week. I'm already low flow.
Mm-hmm.
I'm already using so much less water than most people. Give me the pressure. What are you saving it for, Slim?
How was the shower or facilities at your
fancy hotel
at the Whistler? Yeah. That must have been glorious.
Nice. Yeah, pretty nice.
Was it all in like all?
Did you have a seat?
Like all encompassing?
No, yeah. No seat. I mean, it wasn't.
Sometimes there's
triple tiered.
Some hotels have like pretty crazy. They have that like rain shower overhead or like the.
Yep.
The all jets that come out the walls. Mm-hmm. So this one was a little more modest than that. But
probably because they put all that money in the food budget.
Probs.
Big time.
There was a jacuzzi tub that I did not have an opportunity to hit up, but
that's okay. I hear you.
I used a jacuzzi for the first time this year, actually.
Whoa.
And I fucked up because I didn't realize that.
Sorry, did you
gotta
say
make
first
sure.
time?
Yeah.
Your first time in a jacuzzi?
Yeah, I'd never used them before, and I went to a hotel.
A jacuzzi tub.
Yeah. What else? Other kind of jacuzzis are there?
Well, there's a jacuzzi, like
a hot tub,
popularized in many.
Oh, okay, yeah, I've used hot tubs, but like, like a tub one. Mm-hmm. And I fucked up. I got water everywhere because I didn't wait until they were all the jets were covered. And I was like, I want to get this thing going here, and it was just anarchy in there, like it was chaos. And I was like, okay. Noted. They weren't joking about covering
Chris
those jets.
Chris Martin, ladies and gentlemen. Chris.
So
Martin.
Yeah, it was great though.
Noted jacuzzi enthusiast.
No kidding. Yeah. This is back to though. Back to back week mega fucking excellent stories from Chris Martin, I have to say. That's hilarious. I was like, full stop. You said first time in a jacuzzi. You're like, no. That's fucking, that's hilarious. What did you do to, did you just walk away after?
No, I was in the tub. Like, I was waiting. No, but I was like, hey, get this going. Yeah, but it's a bathroom. It's like stone wall or
no,
whatever. It was nice.
No, you don't just walk away.
It's going to dry.
Yeah. I mean, if anywhere, there's going to be plenty of towels.
Yeah. It was fine. It was not
your place.
That's right.
It was Saavedra for a second. But
speaking of plenty of towels.
My book didn't get wet, so it's good.
Ooh.
Your float house, you get plenty of towels. How many do you want? Go ahead. Give me a number.
I like 2 towels.
Guess what? 3 towels coming your way.
What?
We like to live in excess.
What do you do with the third one? What's that one for?
It's mostly...
It's my business.
Okay.
Do you know those guys that Katie was describing earlier that like stand up in the office tower looking down on the protests? Yeah, the third one, that's just like a status symbol. Like I'm a, oh, you're a 3 towel guy. Oh, I see.
Oh, aren't you Kate 3 towel?
Oh, what?
Yeah.
3 towel as they know you in the urban hood.
Yeah.
I know. Yeah. I've heard of you.
Katie 3T.
I saw a graffiti of you on the wall. I was going to say that like if you come to Float House, come check it out. Definitely, I would recommend this one because this is the one I know. And
okay, don't go to other ones. Just this one.
You could easily go to other ones, but like,
I don't. It's very unlikely that I'm going to go. Yeah. Having now come to a place, it's very unlikely I would go to a different place.
You'd be surprised. Mm-hmm. You'd be surprised. Mm-hmm. You'd be surprised. People come in and they always have an excellent experience here, and then they're like, oh, there's one by my house, and then they go to the one closer or whatever. But you know, it doesn't matter as long as you're like trying it out. It's super cool. I think you'd really love it for just for comedy, like just being able to put. Notes together in your head. That's the thing I love the most about it. Sometimes I jump out and I'm like immediately drying my hands off, trying to fumble for my phone and like start writing right away, like start writing stuff, ideas I had right away. Because, you know, you're in there. You can be like short one, you do like 45 minutes, you can do like 90 minutes. It's great. You love it.
Yeah, I saw the poster when I came in that said 90 minutes, and I was like, that's too many minutes.
My first one was 3 hours.
What?
Yeah, my first one ever. Yeah, right after we closed the arrangement, the deal on this situation, it was like, hey, what are you doing for the next 2 hours?
Moving in.
Yeah. Apparently, do you want to come? Do you want to do 3 hours? And I was like, I've done 0 hours before, and they're like,
come get buried in this water coffin.
Yeah, and I experienced they call it like tank time. I went in there and I had like what I thought was 45 minutes, totally conscious, not sleeping or anything like that, totally conscious 45 minutes. Was exactly like 2 hours and 45 minutes or something like that. And I got out, showered, and looked at my phone and was totally shocked. I actually felt bad that I wasted time because I was like, oh, it's 45. It's only been 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It's, I don't know. You love it.
I mean, probably. I have often, like...
You're in...
I have wished that there was a way you could, like, recreationally try being in a light coma for, like, a short period of time.
There you go.
So this sounds like the closest thing.
Isn't it weird how they, like, have to, like, clip your... fingernails and toenails when you're in a coma?
Oh, yeah.
You heard about this?
Well, like move your legs around and stuff so they don't atrophy completely.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's weird though because like your fingernails keep growing and like your beard grows.
I guess your body.
I
want to
put that into
alive.
Like a thing where it's just like if I get in a coma, don't cut my beard.
Yeah.
I want to see how long that grows well.
Yeah. In the event of coma, just let
it wake up. Just let all of this up here just go for it.
It's strange though. I think that's weird. It's weird how the body kind of just goes on autopilot.
Mm-hmm.
It really gives a lot of credibility to the idea of like you're this like vessel more than you know, like right now, are you, Katie? Are you like in your head or are you like just you in this vessel kind of thing? And that's the kind of question you can unlock in Float House. This is just one big Float House ad. The ad's still going from the beginning. From the beginning.
It's never stopped. Let's jump into the podcast.
Yeah, we can start the podcast now. If you wanna,
Here's our guest, Katie 3 Towel.
Yeah, 3 Towel.
3T.
I'm going to definitely tag you as 3 Towel in this when we post this out. Let me ask you, because this is your first time on the show. We've been chatting a lot about modern events and stuff that's been happening, but how did you get into comedy? What was your first foray into it? Like, how long ago were we talking?
Well, I think I've been doing stand-up now about 9 years. And I always wanted to do comedy.
Always.
When I was a kid.
How young are we talking?
Maybe like 10-ish.
10? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think, if I'm being honest, I think before I knew what comedy was, I thought maybe that I wanted to be an actor.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was then it was brought to my attention around junior high that I was very unattractive. And I was like, that's not going to work out as well for this career.
What?
And then I was like, oh, but people can be funny. I'll do that one.
Oh, my God.
And then, but so I really wanted to be a comedian, but I didn't want to tell anyone that because it seemed wildly arrogant to say like, oh, I want to be. And this was at a time, comedy is so huge now, and there's all these comedy podcasts and things. It's kind of more accessible, but this was not the case at that time.
No, not at all.
And I was living in Victoria, and there wasn't a comedy club, and there's a beautiful scene in Victoria now. It's great. I love it. There's like some of the funniest up-and-coming comics. But that didn't exist then, and so there's kind of nothing. And so I did, took an improv class, because you could take a class for that.
Nah.
I did some very terrible bar improv, not the class's fault. That's on me.
Just as a player.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I've learned this term recently. Went to an improv show last week.
Now he's an expert on it.
Gotta say, I know a lot of stuff now.
Yeah.
Did you hear about this girl that got shot in the face? So, see how that regurgitated non-information happens? That's how it happens. Yeah. So.
And then I got into doing some sketch comedy and things. And through that, I met people that performed and in comedy and things in like the comedy arena in Victoria. Mm-hmm. And I met one other person. A dude that did some stand-up, and then he was running a contest out of the university bar for amateurs, which at that time I thought meant that that everyone on there would be people who have never once done comedy. So I was like, this will be perfect. This is for me. And then I was like real mad if anyone up there and did a joke about like, so I was doing the show, I was like, well, then get out of here.
No kidding, yeah. That's right, hilarious that you're, like, you're like, oh, it's just going to be a bunch of first-timers.
Yeah. And right. the winning prize was $50.
Ooh.
And a spot on this like road show that was coming in, like a roadhouse bar. And I came second.
Second?
So I did not get $50, but they put me on that weird road show anyway.
Oh, wow.
And the rest is history.
That's awesome. So this person that put you on, are they still active?
No, not really. Every once in a while.
I see
him around.
That's good.
Yeah.
Well, if good.
I don't know. He's living a lovely life.
That's good. It's not active. It's good.
Yeah. I was like maybe 5 or 6 years in, and I was at a show at the downtown at Yuck Yucks, and the kid who came first showed up. And I was like, ah, shit.
Oh, right.
And then he went on, and I had now been doing comedy, whatever, 4 or 5 years. And he's like, oh, I just moved to Vancouver. And I was like, oh, great.
Oh, nice.
And then he was doing, and then he did the exact same jokes.
Whoa, really?
Yeah, that he did on that amateur contest.
If it's not broke,
I was like,
don't fix it.
Yeah.
These are all shit advice.
He's a one-liner comedian, like a setup punch comedian.
Yeah.
So, and as such, had like some jokes, a couple of jokes that are just gold. Anyone would want to do them. And then and then other jokes that are just like, well, that's straight garbage. I don't see how this same person wrote both those jokes.
I see.
Like, they're just, it was so wildly inconsistent. I was like, who? Weird. I don't. Do you not see the difference between these two jokes?
I see that in music a lot. I see a lot that they'll have wildly inconsistent material. Wildly inconsistent. Where, like you're saying, like gold, amazing songs that you're like, you have to do that every single time. Don't come to the show if you're not going to do that song. Mm-hmm. Whatever. And then the same group do something that's like, just, like, okay, I see what you're doing, but the execution just isn't there. That kind of thing. That happens all the time. I think it's weird. It's weird when people don't really advance beyond the first step, though. Like, what you if said that, this guy was still doing the same
act. What if that was like his shtick, you know? Like, as somebody who likes comedy a lot, like, and been appreciating it for years, if that was his shtick to just have, like, you know, a few killer one-liners in the midst of, like, ones that are just like,
that'd be an interesting philosophy.
I've never seen him again, not his so shtick. I don't think he had a, like, shtick to speak of.
I moved to Vancouver. I'm about to do a real big. Of that, other people that are like, I know all the comedians. When someone says that, they're like, oh, you do comedy? I know all the comedians. And they do all the shows, that kind of thing. Yeah. When you hear someone say that, you're like, okay, like, what does that mean exactly? Because, like, fuck, the people that do know everyone don't know everyone. Because it's like, you know, like, that's just, it's just not, I don't know. I feel weird. Same thing in music. If someone came up and was like, you perform at this venue? Oh, I know all the people that perform there. You're like, all of them? You must be ridiculously popular. Like, how the fuck do you have time to talk to me?
Dude, it's an open mic night. How exactly. do you know everybody?
Even the people that haven't performed yet?
Yeah, I know. Exactly.
When I meet someone, very often if they find out a comedy, they'll say, oh, my friend does comedy. And then I'll be like, uh-huh. Well, I'm like, oh, who are they? And it's like, I'm going to say 10% of the time. It's someone who does comedy on a regular basis.
Yeah, 10%.
And otherwise, I'm like, oh, that's I don't know that.
That happens even with us. I think like when we're just like, oh yeah, well we interview a lot of comedians on the show, and they're like, oh yeah, my friend does comedy. I'm like, is that right? And they're like, I'm like, what's your friend's name? And they're like, whatever, such and such. And I'm like,
yeah, like just some. There's always cool. like
always
some listener or something like that that's like, oh yeah, you should interview this guy.
Yeah,
he knows all the comedians, and you're just like, what? I'm like, and then you all ask, them, huh? And then I look dumb when I learn now. I don't fucking ask anymore. But like I would ask Grant. I'd be like, hey, do you know so and so? And they're like, no. And then they're like, why? I'm like, oh, some guy said he knew all you, and it's like, no, it just looks bad on us, looks bad on them. I don't want to do it anymore, so I don't.
But like with music, you say like that happens with musicians, but at least like those musicians who say like, oh, I'm in the music scene, it's like they have had to learn a skill that is not innate. They had to learn to like play an instrument. Or
that's super sing debatable. Or something.
I guess maybe, but like
for some people, for sure.
Most people,
right,
have the capacity for speech, and learned a native tongue at one time. And anyone that has those two skills, and go to an open mic.
Stop.
No, you don't.
Stop.
You do not have to have those skills to be a comedian, but they can.
Katie, you're too smart for me to say stop to you again. So I won't. But. That is silly.
I'm not saying they will do a good job, but they can and they will do it.
I can see you say like it's more accessible because like if you have a voice and you have the ability to write some words, you can do this. Not that you'll do well, like you just said.
Or if somebody told you that you were funny in The Office.
Yeah, if you're the Office funny guy and you show up every once in a while, something like that. But like.
I think the level for delusion is lower because like I might think like yeah I bet I would be a great singer songwriter but I would at least have to know that like I do not play an instrument or understand music.
This is so good because again I think you'd be fucking shocked.
But then the level of delusion for comedy is like I'd probably be good at that. Look, I'm already doing it.
All right, so let me just tell you this. This is so when I produce artists and groups. One of the first things I do in our initial sit downs is I do like a goal, like kind of a goal setting.
Uh-huh.
And the amount of times people are like, I want to fucking be successful, rich, and famous. Let's do this.
Oh my God.
Right?
And
it's kind of job as a producer to like you're trying to gauge their expectations and like manage that. Right. So the amount of times I have to rebuttal with like, okay, how about instead of these like very vague, statuses of like rich and famous or something, how about like we opt to tour regionally by this date?
Yeah.
How about we want to do?
People do not understand goal setting.
Right. Yeah. Like
how about
you book a show?
How about one show? Yeah. How about booking
where
one show?
Your name is on the top of the list.
Yeah. How about one headlining show by the end of the year? How about we sell 300 pieces of merch, regardless of what they are, just quantity. We sell 300 pieces of merch within the next, 10 months or something like that. Like I start like building them to-do lists like that, and that is always like yes, because it's like a quantifiable list. You can look at that and say yes, we can crush this. This is something we do. But then like the delusion of like, well, I'm just gonna like if they even knew this like this much. I'm making people listening at home that don't have video.
Yeah.
I'm making a very small amount. If you even had the smallest amount of knowledge about how like a single becomes popular, like an actual like successful like Drake level single, like
I'm sorry, who?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the amount of money
this guy gets shot.
The amount of money that goes into that just to get it to that place. Like people are like, well, people like it, they'll like it. It's like, God, I nope.
Oh my God.
Man, you got to be in a wheelchair in Degrassi at least for 3 or 4 years before you get to that.
At least Kevin Smith has to direct you once. That's at least like you have to.
I had an email from a kid, really, really wants to be a DJ. That's my dream. I got a new album coming out.
Oof.
Wondering if I could help him get on Pemberton Music Fest.
Oh, okay.
Because he saw my, like,
yeah.
Because I played Pemberton Fest. I was like, I don't know how I got on Pemberton Fest. And I was on a comedy stage. And also, there should be way less DJs. That would make my job easier.
That's true.
It was very hard to do comedy over top of DJs.
No kidding. You're like, you're actually killing my momentum.
Yeah. Because I just cannot imagine. And like, part of me wanted to give it up as a kid and be like, man, I would never send that. Like, that's whatever. Who knows how many of these emails he's sending? And probably nothing will come of it. But who knows? There's like, there's a certain amount of like, get it-ness.
Oh,
that,
I see. Yeah.
That I was like, yeah, that's whatever, kid. Good for you. And then there's another piece that I was like, you're doing nothing.
Mm-hmm.
You're like, just blindly sending out Facebook messages to anyone.
Which is
like,
great.
How about you just got? How, why don't you just get good at your? I almost wrote back. I was like, well, do that thing that you like for like a decade more and see if anyone notices.
Yep.
That's right how there. I got on it.
Listen to Katie, kids.
And even then, also then have a driver's license and be a reliable person and drive a bigger artist up there.
That's right. Like, that's, there you go. That's a huge in right there. Yeah. Listen to Katie, kids. Don't, let me just say this, just on a side note, don't blindly ever send out fucking Facebook messages unless you have like a more than 1% chance of actually landing whatever you're asking. Like, even when I reached out to you to do this, we had already talked in person about doing this. So it wasn't like I was blindly, please come do the show.
Well, and even if we hadn't, you could have linked me to it. This is episode 119.
That's right, son. What? Thank you. I almost actually forgot it was 119 until we like literally sat down. But
you've been making a thing consistently.
We've had this show.
Yeah.
Been had it. The ridiculousness of that, though, that we've been doing it this long, it's weird because like you feel like, okay, we've done this many shows. Shouldn't we be blank? And then I have to have my own goal setting session for myself where I'm like, okay, guys, let's relax. Let's not get fucking carried away. Let's just try to make the best quality show every week we can with the most interesting guests we can with people that we feel we want to highlight. That's it. That's like pretty much the standards of this show.
By the end of next month, I would like to have an AI promo code in place.
What? AYE podcast.
I sign up for that.
Nautical bitches.
I would do, yeah. I'd probably use that one.
I.
That's way more fun.
In lieu of I podcast, lowercase I.
Yeah.
Okay.
I will also take a t-shirt that says Nautical by Nature. All right.
Nautical by Nature with the Float House logo. We're just
not doing that.
We're just like,
we got a mouse pad coming soon, apparently.
We're just.
What? Why?
Oh, because we don't have one here. Oh. This doesn't work.
Keep it down. You're going to spoil my surprise.
Well, they won't listen. Down. Next week.
They don't know that.
Whoa.
Well.
I use this weird book.
Actually, hopefully they'll have it by next week. But I keep forgetting it. We bought this gift for Vancouver Real, who do their show here as well. And just like, because there's no mouse pad. We always use. Like,
and this doesn't work. Stuff. The mouse doesn't work on
So we just took their logo and made a mouse pad. By the way, ordering a mouse pad online, not the fucking easiest thing in the world.
I believe it.
Everywhere I look, the first like four sites I look to, they're like, so how many do you want? 400? 300?
I'm like, whoa,
300 mouse pads? They're like, yeah. I'm like, what's the smallest amount I can order? They're like, 75. And I was like, that's still way too many.
74
podcasts.
Too many.
Yeah, I'm like, way too many. I'm like,
you can do that shit at London Drugs.
I was about to say, I was like, that seems like a London Drugs ass.
See, but then I'd like getting to leave a mug the couch. Made. Yeah.
No, what? You would not have to. I mean, to pick it up, probably.
To pick it up, yeah. See? This got delivered.
Right, oh, good lord.
Whoa.
So needy.
Hey, two showers a week, three towels.
Yeah. I'm out and about living life, man.
How dare you? How dare you call me out? My obviously lazy, inactive behavior. How dare you?
I'm sorry. The debate at the gig today, this afternoon, was shopping malls versus online shopping. So I am team shopping malls 100%.
Oh, really?
Oh, really?
Yeah. I didn't know. Oh,
that seems like a losing position.
What? Get out.
I'm also all about.
I love
going
the mall.
Out to shop.
Really?
Oh, man. Shop. Yes.
Not about, no. I don't like to take risks on what I'm purchasing.
For me, it's not even about purchasing. I literally just like being at the mall. I like the atmosphere.
Have you always
getting
liked
an Orange Julius?
Yeah.
When I was growing up in my small town, our mall was like just like basically a strip mall with a tunnel. It was really nothing much. I even worked there at one point, like at one of the stores. And it was always shit. So when I where I'd go to like a big city like Winnipeg,
yes.
which is like not at all. But you go like
Thunder Bay.
Thunder Come on Bay, now. Go to Thunder Bay.
Okay.
You go to like a place with an actual mall. I was always like, yeah, I like it here. I love it.
No.
And then you work in a few malls and you're like, no, I hate malls. I fucking
it. It feels like a 90s thing.
To like malls. The mall?
Yeah. The only 90s. Time I like malls are like Tuesday afternoons.
That's a good when no mall one's there. Time.
Yep. Good. I fucking hate people. Check it out. Yeah. That's not true. I love malls. I love people. I hate fucking people at malls. All the time.
I love a crowded mall. I don't care. I'll go in the holidays when
you
I
must
don't
love Christmas.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, really? I love it.
December 19th, you're right there.
Oh man,
bring the thick
23, 24. Y'all get in.
Oh, 23.
Yeah,
you're wild. You're too much. I can't handle this. 23, 24.
A masochist, maybe.
The thing. I get grief about it too. But it's just like
it's great.
I don't understand what's so bad about it.
I just
people
suck.
Put your headphones in or whatever if you're by yourself and just walk around the mall.
Yes.
It's not that bad.
I'm just.
You go to the boyfriend station where they're heavy. All just stranded in the weird couches waiting for something.
Boyfriend station.
they got a hockey game on.
Yeah, always.
It's like.
That's a good addition they've done recently. That's definitely a good thing.
There's so much shit to see.
The thing I hate the most is that.
I've never seen before at the mall when I was there.
No. The thing I hate the most, though, without a doubt, is the fact that, like, I can dress however I need to prepare for the outdoor elements. And whenever I go inside, nope. You're three layers too many.
Too hot.
They have a fucking coat check at the mall.
That's the bullshit that I have to check my coat.
Well, if you're wearing 900 layers
of the mall.
This
is not an issue with the mall. This is indoors and outdoors. That would happen in any establishment.
No, it's too hot in there.
I'm just a sweaty fuck.
The same at restaurants.
You're right.
The bus, that also happens.
I don't like to eat here because I wore three sweaters today. Like, get out of here. Fuck off.
It's ridiculous. Cater to my fashion choices. This is ridiculous.
I don't like people that work at the mall. Like, they're fine, but like, I don't like being like asked. Like, I'm there, and they're like, hey, can I help you? I'm like, no, I don't want to deal with anybody, but their job is that, and they won't leave you alone. Like, that's how
they would get fired.
Headphones. Yeah, but see, that's why the mall is great and why I won't fuck with boutiques.
Okay. Boutiques.
Boutique? Nope. I'm embarrassed.
Three tall would say boutiques.
Triple T.
Yeah, it's like my buddy Boutique.
Let me tell you. Throw a feature
you go
in front
you
of
it. Like and I mean, I love Main Street. I love little shops, and I like buying local stuff. But if you go in and there's no other person in that store,
yeah,
I'm a boat face. I'm getting
out. I almost immediately leave,
yeah.
Yeah,
but in the mall, there's always someone else there. It's the best.
That's fair.
That is, okay. You have kind of convinced me a little bit on that. That is true.
So fun.
Although
so did you win the debate?
Yeah. Son, of course it did.
Of course.
You know Baby Girl Undefeated?
What? Three towels, son. Or three tray, as we like to roll around. I like this. your comedy has, like, I've always liked watching you. And I've always liked watching your shows. I think you do fantastic performances. You always stand out, which is fucking awesome. But I'd like to know, because we're talking about goals and stuff. Do you have future goals that you've been thinking about? Maybe something you want to like throw out there into the universe that you're just like, this is gonna happen. I talked about it on a podcast once.
Oh yeah.
And something like that. By the way, this is the podcast.
Oh, this one.
This is the one.
Yeah, I do. I'm big on goal setting. I do not want to throw it out on the podcast because I.
Come on.
No.
You're gonna be vulnerable with us.
I will. I mean, no. Thank you.
I let you know that I fall in and out of love with showers. How about that?
That's very intimate.
That's a very vulnerable thing to let people know. People start looking at you sideways. They're like, yeah, you do kind of smell. You fucking. Degenerate.
It's a podcast, man. They can't smell you.
One day they'll meet me, though. Maybe. Probably not. But then I have to worry if they will say something or if they're being polite and they don't say anything. See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Try and be vulnerable with you. Wait, so you're not going to share this right now after all this buildup? You're not going to tell us the one goal that you're going to put together? Why? No?
I'm being squirrely. I'm being real squirrely.
You are being squirrely.
Is it because, like, I've heard sometimes if you want to do something, you shouldn't tell somebody because then it's like.
Is that the reason?
Because then it feels good to say the thing.
Oh, yeah. I have heard that as well. It feels like you get the same satisfaction
exactly.
of having already done it. And mm-hmm. people are like, yeah, totally. Mm-hmm.
Or is it different reasons?
It's totally a different reason.
Not that one.
No, okay. It's totally a different reason.
It was definitely that.
Yeah. All right. I'll let you off the hook.
Okay.
I don't. See, we should bring back segments like Too Offensive.
And where's our segment for Fuck Steve McGowan?
Oh, I don't need a segment. Fuck that guy.
Fuck Steve McGowan. We love Steve McGowan so much, and he's rescheduled on us 2 weeks in a row. And not to mention, we're just trying to plug his show at the Laugh Lines next month with Sonny.
Why are we plugging it?
Well,
for Sonny's sake?
Sonny Dollarwell, yeah. Best.
We're actually like anti-plugging it right now because we're not really plugging it. We're just saying that we were going to be plugging it.
And does anyone have good dirt on Steve McGowan that we can use?
We this love McGowan impromptu so much segment? That this would be amazing. Yeah,
like, I had good dirt on
yeah,
him.
Perhaps. Yeah, perhaps.
Have you ever just met him? He's probably got enough dirt going on.
Yeah.
Seems he's a good guy. Hey. C-Mart tried to start a Fuck Steve McGowan segment. And
I jumped right on board.
I know. She was in. She was right in.
I didn't question it for a second.
I feel like this might be a thing with just about anybody who would be here. Any comedian. Yeah, fuck that guy, man.
Just start it up. Yeah. I think we'd have to finesse that a little bit.
Sure. What's a work in progress?
Because some of the delusion stuff we were talking about
earlier.
We'll write
a theme song. It'll be good.
People might get a little disillusioned. They might be like, do they really fucking hate me? Do they really want to say fuck you to me? Some people might be really offended. I'm sure that person exists. Definitely music.
It's definitely sure. Steve. He's the one that's offended.
Steve
he seems easily offended. No, he's very thin-skinned.
No, he's not.
We're in the segment definitely still, not. By the way.
Yeah, we're still in the segment, everyone.
No, nope, that guy will not be deterred.
Yeah, he's...
Believe me, I've tried.
Jesus.
I have not tried.
Nah, he's fantastic. We love him. But we also love you, and I think that you're amazing, and...
I know, but now that I know that you like Steve McGowan, I don't feel like that
means
anything.
Oh, shit.
See?
Segment lives.
It's the best segment we've
ever done. The segment doesn't actually end. Now is just the theme has been introduced that...
Actually, here's
I feel I'm uncomfortable with the segment now. I take it all back. I'm sorry.
No kidding. Here's actually an unofficial little weird kind of rule, like a curse almost that's happened on the show.
A hex?
Mm-hmm. Anytime... we have announced at the end of an episode who the next week's guest is. They never show up.
Oh, I haven't noticed this.
Something always happens.
True.
Something always fucking happens.
What's an example of this?
I can't do this because then they might miss the next one. Do you see what I'm saying? I'm trying to avoid doing it.
That hasn't come on?
Didn't we say that Steve was going to be here last week?
I mean, in this case, this is the first time that the actions of Steve McGowan have really worked out in my favor.
That's totally right.
And it has Here's been awesome thing. That I get to be here.
My favorite part of this, though, is that when at first you were like, I don't know if I'm going to get back from this corporate gig in Whistler in time. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay. I called Steve because he was going to be on the show next week anyway. And then he was like, oh, yeah, I'll do it. No problem. And then I had already confirmed with him twice during the week if he would do it. And then yesterday I jokingly messaged him to say, just want to make sure you're still on board. And he's like, ellipsis.
Ah.
Bro, you're going to fucking kill me. Yes, I am going to kill you. And then I was like, oh my God, well, what about our original booking? And you're like, hey, just want to let you know I can actually do it. I was like, yes. So it worked out. So actually for a while there, Steve just kind of kept your seat warm for some reason. And then you were always booked. You're always going to be here at this date. It was in the stars, like I said.
It was in the stars.
In the fucking stars.
I can tell you, noon comedy really works out well for my lifestyle. I do not. It's my least favorite thing about comedy is that it happens at night.
Is that why? Because your nights are just...
I'm a morning person.
Oh, really?
Oh, so you like this corporate thing timing-wise.
Yeah,
it's
rare to go.
Wait a minute.
It could have been at soundcheck time. I've been like, let's do it now. I'm ready.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, what time do you usually get up then?
Like 6:30.
6:30?
Wow.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Are you like one of these people that wakes up because you want like an hour to yourself first and stuff like that? Or like...
No, I get up right about it.
Right and get going.
Yeah.
Interesting. Okay. I've never been one of those people to have like...
Up early all the time, regardless of whatever happens.
Really? Damn. I'm such a night owl. I'm up working till like 2 or 3, 4, mm-hmm. something like that, and then I'll sleep for a couple hours, and then maybe get up, work, forget to sleep, that stuff, forget to eat. You know, just regular life.
Yeah.
Forget to sleep after just sleeping.
Yeah, forget to sleep. Things. Yeah, to finish the only few hours I got. That kind of thing. But this isn't about me. This isn't about me and your weird thing, C-Mart. That's what I'm trying to say. Just give me the light. See that?
I did.
Gave me the light.
Yeah.
I'm
a pro. I know when I know when I'm getting the light.
You are absolutely a pro.
You know, I'm having a very good time.
That's right. You can watch
Thank
Katie.
Thank you all for coming.
It's not my list. MD sets the limit.
Katie's going to be appearing. What's the full name of the festival?
Just for Laughs Northwest.
What? That's it.
Just for Laughs Northwest. Northwest. You can catch her at the following dates. These are actual Just for Laughs Northwest dates, right?
Yes, that's correct.
Part of the festival.
Part of the festival.
Yeah, and then I realized, though, that the one you pimped, I forgot that Barely Legal is already sold out.
Oh, but we can pump that right now.
That's true. It's real.
You cannot catch her at Barely Legal on February
17th. Unless you have tickets.
It's sold out unless you have tickets. And guess what, folks? You should have got them earlier. That's how hot this show is. Make sure you remember the name, Katie Ellen Humphries.
But also on the 17th, earlier that night at 8 p.m., I will be on Graham Clark's The Quiz Show.
Oh, go to that. That's super fun.
Go to Hot Art Wet City. It's going to be so fun.
And go there anyway because you won't be able to go there for very much longer.
They've got lots of shows during the festival, and they'll all be stacked. And yeah, there's only a couple more months of that awesome art space gallery being available to the public.
Which is unfortunate because of the trend of the city right now. It's really bad because, yeah, fuck, man. They're one of the great venues in the city that actually puts art up, like all types of art, not just performance art, like, mm-hmm. which is great. Mm-hmm. You'll also be at Stacked, great comedy show on the 20th.
That is at Yaggers in Kitsilano.
What? Yaggers in Kitsilano. Do you like that room?
I do, yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty nice. I this came up earlier this week. Someone asked me what my favorite room was in the city, and I was like, I don't know. I kind of like them all. There's like, I guess, I don't know. I don't want to say like, oh, this is the worst one or something.
What about the place under the Goldie's restaurant? Oh. Have you been there?
Which one are you talking about?
The Goldie's restaurant.
No, I know, but like,
they run a number of different shows there.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah. Every show. Hilarious that Chris Martin would bring
this up. That one always seemed like, right. That one seems like very off the like beaten path in terms of like, I don't know though.
Yeah.
I don't even think they do. They still host shows at the original Goldie's in the basement that Chris Martin's referring to.
I believe so. I don't know if there's weeklies anymore. I mean, I'm sure there are. I don't know the details of who runs every night or whatever.
I think it changed quite a few times.
There's still comedy at Goldie's Pizza.
Okay.
But who cares about that? Because we're talking about Kino.
Oh, I love the Kino Cafe.
On February 21st. That's going to be an excellent show. Who else is on the bill on that one?
I'm not sure of the lineup on that one yet, but I know it's going to be all local heavy hitters for the fest.
Absolutely good taste, no question. And you are the guest comedian on Sunday Service on February 26th.
Yes.
I said on Sunday Service. At Sunday Service.
I'm going to be at it. I'm going to be on it. I'm going to be about it.
That's right. Around, son. I like how urban we've been degenerating. Like, we started off like, hello, wow, nice to meet you.
And space.
Now it's like three towels, y'all. Two chains, three towels. February 26th. That's going to be a great, great show. What's the venue there?
That's at the Fox Cabaret. Every Sunday, in fact.
Excellent. That is awesome. How can people follow you online if they are so inclined to do so?
Ooh, I would love if they were to follow me on Twitter. I'm at Miss Katie Ellen, MSKATIEELLEN.
Excellent.
That's the best way.
Is that your preferred social media?
Yeah, I like that in Instagram.
Yeah.
It's my faves.
IG always gets a lot of love.
Yeah.
I think that
more IG.
More Instagram, more Twitter, like that kind of thing.
Yeah, if you're interested in finding out where I'll be for performing, then it's a good idea to follow me on Twitter. If you're interested in seeing jokes that I see around the city or weird hats that I wear, then you know, you might want to jump on that IG as well.
Weird hats?
I don't know.
What the?
Dumb outfits or whatever.
We get you, this is your second show of the day. So we're like, you're like, all right, I used A material all day. And
yeah.
That's okay. Like,
no, I was corporate clean all day. That's why you're getting three towels up in
That's
here.
Right. Corporate clean, super breakfast.
Yes.
I understand. It's okay. I get it. I know where we are in your priority. I know. It's okay. C-Mart, if people want to follow you, how can they follow you online?
It's not a thing.
I knew it.
Whoa.
It's not a thing. It's too humble.
So cool.
It's too, yeah, right? It's the coolest thing. It's just like, nope, can't do it in this day and age. And I respect him. I applaud him for that. Saavedra just stepped out. I don't know where he is, but you can follow Saavedra at The Saavedra on Instagram and on Twitter.
Is that just how it sounds?
The Saavedra.
Two A's. Multiple. There's lots of A's in his name.
I'm just kidding. I have no idea how it's spelled.
How many A's are in your name? Four? Five? Are you sitting down now?
How many A's?
Yeah.
Four.
Four A's.
A lot of A's.
Yeah, a lot of A's.
And if you follow the podcast, we'd really appreciate it. We love hearing from you guys, feedback and stuff. This week, I heard good stuff. I saw Gob shared our interview with.
I love Gob.
We love Gob.
Oh, I love him.
Gob shared our video today from our interview with Theo last year. So, just a year.
Not the first show.
A year late, but that's okay. I'll take it. Yeah, that was C-Mart's first show actually with the podcast, so that was pretty funny. But yeah, they shared that today. But yeah, we love hearing feedback from people. I heard another thing today that said the crew episodes, they love those. Keep putting those out. That was awesome. We tend to do just guest-less shows
every
once in a while. And
I love that.
Yeah, we're learning to love it. That kind of thing. It's nice. It's just a different dynamic, right?
Yep.
But yeah, if you follow us, you can go to you can just search Intergalactic Interviews on iTunes or Stitcher or YouTube, and go ahead and subscribe to us. Make sure you subscribe to our video channel. Subscribe to us on iTunes, wherever you get your podcast. We're endeavoring to be there, so you can find
us. Maybe leave us a review.
Well, I'd love if you leave us a review. If you're listening to this right now, leave us a review, because we're shameless that way. We want, you know, bad reviews. Good reviews, whatever it takes. You know, you let me know, and we'll make it happen. No? This is a terrible pitch to make someone want to watch
I was trying
the
to
show.
Make some shitty comment, but I just left it.
That's okay.
I don't know.
That's okay. C-Mart, you've been killing it today.
Buck Steve McGowan.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. I knew it.
That's what I was thinking. I was like, trying to work Steve McGowan negative reviews
into my... We're
going
to put that on Instagram. We're going to put that on Instagram for Steve. Definitely. We love Steve.
We got to Snapchat him after this just to really get at him.
Definitely. He's going to be like, what the fuck, guys? It's like 2 solid minutes. Fuck Steve going. Fuck. I guess that's it.
Thank you so much for having me. I had a really great time.
Yeah, thanks for coming to the show.
Yeah.
We really appreciate you being here.
Beautiful ending.
This is our sloppiest ending of all time, by the way. I'm just like, and that's it. Okay. Bye. Bye. So, no, thanks for coming to the show. Will you come back and do it very soon?
Yes, please.
We would love that big time. That being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to subscribe and share if you like it, and if you don't, well, we'll endeavor to change your mind. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you all next week with a guest we can't announce so they don't cancel on us. Yay. Okay, we'll see you all in a little bit.
See ya. Mwah.